This video is made possible by the ABS-CBN Film Restoration Project.
Sa wakas, isang bansa nga diktate sa alas! Wala nang takas ang buong Pinas! Mabuhay!
The choice of restoring Kakabakaba was made by ABS-CBN. The decision to partner with Rovata was a discussion with them, largely because also the materials were also not in the Philippines. So it just made more sense for us also to do the restoration with Rovata. At the same time, Mike De Leon was also very comfortable with the company because they had also done Maynila sa Kukunang Liwanag, Insiang, and most recently, Portrait of an Artist. Ever since we started the restoration in 2011, what we wanted was to get the audience to become more familiar with the classics. That's the basic problem. Most of them didn't know the classic titles. They had forgotten the directors. They had forgotten the older titles. But it's also a calibrated or a planned activity. So, you know, every year we try to ramp it up. And we were just lucky that this 2015, that's also the time that we had access to a lot of the good movies with a lot of materials that were surfacing. For some of them, we thought there were no materials available anymore. And, you know, we try to partner with different laboratories, with different archives. Like, for example, with Retrovata, we will try to ask them also, are they aware if there are any existing materials that we could tap? So, like, for example, some of the materials are found not in Asia but are in Europe, and they would have access to it also.
Tama ka. Nasa akin ang lahat. Kahit langit makukuha ko kung gusto ko. Pero anahin ko langit kung di kita kate.
Well, we are always looking for Mike De Leon movies because he didn't really do as many movies. But more often than not, our problem is which titles are we going to get access to first. So like the first movie that we were able to restore was Hindi Nahahati Ang Langit. And then fortunately, Kakabakaba and Kumangarap Ka, after about 3 years of negotiations, we were finally able to work out the details. So hence, these are the movies that are being restored now.
Melanie, wala sakit!
Marami na kaming gulong napasukan dahil dyan sa cassette na yan. Ilang beses nang nalagay sa peligro ang buhay namin. Ngayon, ang gusto namin malaman kung ano talagang klaseng cassette ito.
Kung hindi niyo ibig matupan ang bawat ng ating grandmaster sa Japan.
Well, a lot of the negotiations do take long. On average, they're like 2 years. Longer than the restoration. So in the case of these movies, like even Ikaw Ay Akin and Kakabakaba and Kumangarap Ka't Magising, the discussions had been ongoing for a long time. And sometimes also, it's a function of technology. Maybe there were certain things that we could not do very, very well way back in 2011 and in 2012. But for example, talking to Retrovata, they've actually had more success also in doing a lot of cleanups in the last couple of years, maybe, for example, because all of the technology keeps being improved upon. So things like molds and fungus were more problematic a few years back, but now they actually do have a software that with the grading of the film actually improves it and removes it at a far quicker pace.
Okay, the restoration of this film took 5 months. Yeah, 5 months, right. But usually it takes even longer, okay? But as we have a very tight deadline,
yes.
We try to speed up the process, but usually restoration takes time. Mm-hmm. Above all, when you have such a kind of problem like mold, that you need time to completely fix the problems. No, the main issue was the mold. And in fact, you can discover the condition of the film only when you receive the film,
yes,
and when you scan the film.
Okay.
And for this film, after the scanning, we just realized that mold was everywhere. And then started the challenge, I mean.
Yes.
But so now I'm very happy about the quality of the restoration, but took longer than planned.
I think a major problem we have really is the younger audience isn't really familiar with the works of the Mike De Leons and the Lino Brocas, the Ismael Bernals. So what the Film Restoration Project is trying to do is to make sure that these masters will survive through the survival of their works.
Yeah, and thanks to the restoration today, the film will have a second life.
Correct. It will also be available, aside from theaters, on television, on cable, hopefully on iTunes, and all of the other digital platforms. And you know, that's the wonder of restoration. We are able to give a brand new coat, a brand new look to a lot of these classic movies.
The basic workflow of a restoration is to repair the film when we receive the reels, because the reels are damaged, we have to physically repair with our hands, and then after a washing, we are able to scan the film, usually in 4K. After the scanning, the digital restoration starts. I mean, we have to fix all the scratches, we have to make stabilization, the flicker, and so on. And this is the longest step. As soon as the picture is completely clean, we start the color correction in order to respect the original look of the film. In the same time we are restoring the picture, we restore the sound. We have to physically repair the optical soundtrack or the mux, and then to digitize the sound, to clean up the sound, and to do the sound. Okay? At the very end of the workflow, the restored picture and the restored sound, they are getting married, in fact, in the final deliverables, like digital deliveries or as well photochemical preservation element. Really depend on the request.
I'd also like to add, in instances when we can consult with the original cinematographer or the director, yeah, we will get their inputs also. Just so, for example, with the grading and the correction, we will get it correctly. As much as possible, what we're trying to do is to bring it back to the original condition, not make any changes,
right,
to the movie, because that's a totally different field already. We try to be as respectful to the source material.
For picture and sound.
Yes. Yes. This movie probably pokes fun at practically everybody. Blacks, Chinese, Japanese. But you know, that was part of the humor at that time. I think you look at it in the context of the period. You're not going to take offense to it. I remember being alive at that time. And you know, those things were part of the language. So
the,
yeah, and you know, they were more for fun. More than anything else. So
like, now it's like a document.
Correct. Really.
I mean, there's a second interest.
And it just shows also how avant-garde we can be, or how forward-thinking we can be. Because however you look at it, this movie is way ahead of its time. This was done in 1980, when a lot of the black comedies that were being done and a lot of the musicals that were being done were very, very different also. So you know, Mike De Leon is clearly a visionary. And it's just good that, you know, we've been able to restore this and put it out there. Just people, so people will see that, you know, Mike De Leon is somebody we shouldn't forget. He was really a great filmmaker. You know, I think people are actually more sensitive now. We tend to be so politically correct now that we make issues of everything. I think at the time that this movie was done, yeah, it's par for the course. It's fair game. People were not reacting too vehemently. It was meant for laughs, so they would laugh. They would enjoy the movie. Everybody takes the time to watch the restored titles. Sometimes during the premieres, we don't have enough slots, but we're trying to work with theaters so that we could have actually a commercial run for these movies. So when those runs do happen, I hope you do come out and show your support. I promise you there's a lot to enjoy, and you'll discover how great Filipino cinema has been, and we should never forget that.